going to need another player to fill out this table, and we have just the man for the job. Please welcome the co-founder of Apple, Steve Wozniak, ladies and gentlemen.
Coming up. The girl that we were talking about that you signed the baby book for?
No, yeah.
Her water broke in the audience, and she had to leave.
No, I just heard this, by the way. This is before we even start True Confessions. This really happened. Your guest that was with you tonight, she was up in the audience, and she was pregnant. And you told me before the show, you said she's 3 weeks out. And you go, don't make her laugh. Don't make her laugh too. Yeah, I just signed her baby book for her. You go, don't make her laugh too. Anyways, her water broke during a commercial break, and she's great. Everything's great. She's on her way to the hospital right now. Congratulations. That really happened just now.
That's amazing.
Well, they actually took her upstairs, and she's having the baby in Lauren's office.
Woz, welcome. Thank you for joining us. In front of each of us are two envelopes containing confessions. And one of the envelopes is something that actually happened to us in real life. And the second envelope is a lie. Once you read your confession, the other two players have 60 seconds to interrogate you. Okay? Then they each have to guess whether you've been lying or telling the truth. We'll take one turn each. Seth will go first. Steve, which envelope should Seth open? Number one?
Two.
Ooh, very decisive.
Confident.
Very decisive,
well, they're both powers of two, so they're both good numbers.
All right.
I judge things that way.
Of course. Duh. I didn't want to say it.
Keep up, Fallon.
I'm glad I said it.
Come on.
That he said it, yeah.
Exactly. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
I once took mushrooms at a party with Wolf Blitzer.
Okay, we have 60 seconds. Now, you say with Wolf Blitzer. Does that mean he took mushrooms as well?
He did.
Where was the party?
In Malibu, California.
What was it about?
It was a friend's party at their house in Malibu.
Why would Wolf Blitzer be there?
Someone knew Wolf Blitzer.
Oh, come on.
Who provided the mushrooms?
I provided the mushrooms.
Did Wolf Blitzer know he was eating mushrooms?
He did.
And who offered it? You?
I offered Wolf Blitzer the mushrooms.
Were these psychedelic mushrooms?
They were psychedelic
mushrooms.
Oh, that's
a good question. Was there music playing?
There was
what
music
song?
Playing. At the moment that
yes!
we ate the mushrooms.
Yes, what song? You had to remember you were doing truth
with
Wolf
Blitzer.
Yeah.
I don't remember the specific song that was playing at that moment.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah.
Who was DJing?
There was no DJ. It was an iPod was
many,
actually playing music. How many people were at the house altogether?
Yeah, you, Wolf Blitzer.
16 to 20.
How big was the hot tub?
Not big enough.
Whose house was it?
All right. Ooh. Okay, we're out of time. I don't know.
I think he's telling the truth.
You do?
I think he's telling the truth because he would have known what the lie was, and he would have had an instant answer to that one question that he stumbled on. So I'm going to go with the truth. I mean, it doesn't sound like Wolf Blitzer, does it?
We can
hedge our bets.
I would say normally, no, he didn't. That's not true. It's Wolf Blitzer. He would never do that. But then again, it's Seth Rogen. So at this point, we might have done mushrooms with Seth Rogen. I mean, we shook his hand. I don't know how it travels.
It's just, through skin. Yeah.
I'm going to say that it's a lie.
It's a lie.
Yeah! There we go. See? Woo! Wolf! Right now, Wolf Blitzer is calling his lawyer. Right? Okay.
It was Ron Rifkin, and I thought it was Wolf Blitzer.
All right, here we go. It's
true
my
story
turn.
About the wrong person.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, which envelope should I open? One or two?
One.
You say it's not you just said two in the same.
Well, they're both binary. They're both good numbers. I look at hotel room numbers. Mine is 4925. Well, 49 is 7 squared. 25 is 5 squared. Or 16, 4 squared. And then it was 49. 4 and 9 are both squares.
Yeah.
It's a good room number. It's a good room.
They
That's
are.
How I judge the rooms.
Very nice. Very
exactly.
Good.
Keep up, Fallon.
when we were in college, my friend broke his leg stealing candy from a vending machine.
Do we go?
Yeah.
Did he have the money to pay for it and he just chose to steal it?
Yeah, sure.
What kind of vending machine?
It was a candy machine.
Was it a college?
Yes.
Was it in a dorm?
Yes.
Did it tip over and fall on him?
Yeah.
Was he trying to shake something out of it?
Yeah. It was like you guys were there.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, yeah, it fell on him and then we
Did you witness it?
I didn't witness the fall.
You but witnessed,
I witnessed the aftermath. Yeah.
Did you call the police?
We dragged him into the snow and then told him to tell the police he got hit by a car.
Really?
Yeah.
Because you're afraid of the criminal element of the situation.
That's correct. Yeah. It was...
Did he get the thing out of the vending machine?
No.
Did the whole vending machine fall and smash?
Yes.
But he didn't take the thing out of it.
We weren't worried about the candy.
Because did it fall on his whole body or just his leg? Oh. What do you think,
Wallace? And it was wolf blitz.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I think it's true, but it was a girl and not a guy. You're doing one of these little slight changes.
Interesting. Whoa. Wow. I'm gonna say it's not true.
It is true, and it was a guy. I didn't change it really. I didn't change it. That's a true story. That's a true story. Hi, Mark. He's a teacher somewhere right now. Hi, Mark.
He didn't take the candy.
No, we were too freaked out.
It was really freaky.
Yeah, it was really, it didn't make any sense. All right.
I'm not an actor, so this is hard for me, but pick one of them.
Well, it's pretty simple. I'm going to go with two.
Obviously.
Yeah, I mean, every time I go.
It's a binary number.
Yeah, it's a binary number. If I get on the freeway, take the 495 because 4 plus 9.
It's 2.
Two minus 5 and divided by 4.
Steve Jobs and I were once robbed at gunpoint outside a pizza parlor.
Okay. Where were you?
Sunnyvale, California.
What year was it?
About 1972.
1972.
Had
you eaten or were you about to eat?
We had eaten.
What kind of pizza did you eat?
Pepperoni.
Steve ate pepperoni?
In those days. This is Steve Zero, before Apple.
Steve Zero. Never heard of that one. She walked out, and the guy just came out of an alleyway like a movie?
No.
Did he put the gun in your face?
Car.
He was in the car.
He didn't point the gun at us, but he made the gun visible through the window of the car.
Really?
He was in the car.
No, he was standing outside.
Steve Jobs and I were in the car.
Yeah, and did you have a weapon?
No.
Whose car was it?
I can't remember.
I think it was Steve Jobs.
What were you driving?
I seem to recall Steve in the driver's seat and me behind him.
Yeah, what kind of car it was?
Would have been his. If it was my car, it was a Pinot.
Yeah, but if it was his car, what was it?
I don't remember.
Oh, really? Interesting.
A Dodge Dart. Probably a Dodge Dart.
Probably. Yeah. Busted hard there. I don't know, but this one.
He held up under pretty intense questioning.
Yeah, I tried to make him stumble about the
car.
No,
it didn't work.
It didn't quite work.
I honestly don't think it's true.
I forgot to ask him, like, what happened and how did he get out of it?
Yeah, exactly. I assume that you gave him everything you had.
Yeah.
Well, it turns out he was only stealing one thing, and he gave us his name and phone number.
What?
He only stole one thing that we had shown him in the pizza parlor, and he gave us his name and phone number.
I'm so confused right now.
Of course. He kind of stole it. One of these little devices for, like, making free calls that I had built. And he stole it.
Is this true?
And then he came back to the car window and he gave us his name and phone number. He said, because I think he was half honest, he said he wanted to pay for it, but he didn't have the money right then.
Did he have a gun?
He was half honest.
And he did have a gun. So it really happened.
He also wanted to know how to use it.
So he stole a thing he didn't know how to use.
Was this Bill Gates?
Yeah, exactly.
You don't have to tell. I don't remember. Our thanks to Seth Rogen, Steve Wozniak.
True.
It was true.
True story.